Thank you for joining us here on our the second of two nights here in the gym. How many of you all were at the show last night? Just curious. Is there anything we need to talk about before we begin? No, you can use a flash. Were you not here last night? So you already know when we last played here. Okay. For those who didn't know, last time we played in Boston was 11 years ago. Go figure. Actually, no, correction. It was last night.
Thank you. cut up my mouth. First, it feels to allow you. That's not too easy to do. I'm sure I lick my lips when I need it. I will not lick them.
It's much cooler in here tonight. Jack Frost. It's very good. Sort of a, it's a wintry kind of reference. It's good. Why do we stay late for so long? We didn't. Well, we actually didn't try to stay away. We were having difficulties booking shows here because most of the larger venues in this city are run by promoters that were not interested in doing shows for low ticket prices. And then another thing developed where suddenly all ages shows were also ruled illegal by the city, which is insane, you know. But because we only play shows that are all ages, and because we are concerned about how much the tickets cost, the only way we can really contend with those sorts of challenges is to say, no, we will not play your venue at those kind of, under those conditions. So we played around Boston, but not in Boston proper. Does that answer your question?
Here's one for Jody, a song called Birthday for Me.
We'll be right back.
torture, whatever degree, pain and bad things are headed to me. Now it's hard to punch a car on a side with production star. I'm a warehouse with a job. Some something, some someone. Tasky time with a tag and I. Knowledge moves one step at a time. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Life's been ripped you right to pieces. They get tired of trying to be free, yeah. Don't run with the other people.
Informal poll, because every day I look in the paper and there's a new poll that says that President George Bush has like 800% of the American public behind him, so, and everyone that I know never seems to get the polling phone call. So I'd like to do a poll in this room. How many people here, quite honestly, have health insurance? Raise your hand. Y'all got health insurance? How many people here don't have health insurance? Looks about 70 with, 30 without, kind of. Most people I know, I have health insurance, but most people I know in D.C. do not have health insurance. And I was talking to a kid I saw today on Newbury Street, and he's studying to be a nurse. And he said one of the classes that he's taking right now that is a real bummer for him is a whole class devoted to understanding insurance form legalese instead of studying the medicine of how to help people. This is a song called Give Me the Cure.
Come on, give me the pill, boy, girl. One, two.
Hey. Thank you. a big problem. There's a big problem, not a problem for me. And inside, no, I'm broken, but I'm working as far as you can see. We took a drive around town, and we were talking to a friend of ours who lives here, and he was saying, oh yeah, I used to live right here, it was $35 a week, and now it's $2,000 a month, and I lived over here, and it was, you know, $10 a month. You know, the point is that at some point, living in the city was actually an affordable option. And I think Boston has, along with Washington, D.C. and San Francisco, and a couple other places, has a distinction of being completely, insanely, absurdly expensive. And what's... We have an announcement.
Sarah Lou's roommate, Tony, we need him in the back at public safety. She passed out up front. Can you go back over there if you're still here? Thank you. Sorry to ruin the show.
Say it again.
Sarah Lou's roommate, Tony, are you here?
Tony!
Well, if that doesn't work,
Johnny!
I haven't heard anything about what happened down in Washington today, but there was a very huge protest. We hope it was huge. And I know there was also a protest here in Boston, which is great. I actually think that every time there's a protest in Washington, there should be a protest in every city. You know, this is... And I saw a guy today. You know, we're hanging on Newberry Street. That's a pretty cool street, you know? You're right, we were in your store, sir. But we were talking to, I talked to a guy and he said, yeah, I don't know, I went to the protest today, but I don't really know if it changed anything. And sir, I know you're not here because you said you weren't coming tonight, but sir, the point is, you alone may not change anything. The point is, there are a lot of people in this country who think that what the government is doing and what the military is doing, what all these security forces are doing, what the NSA is doing, the CIA and the FBI, and all these motherfuckers who have so much money, endless amounts of money, and this completely insane fundamentalist freak, John Ashcross, and this... There are a lot of people in this country who already disagree with them, and as sort of the feeling starts coming back into their blood, there's going to be a lot more people starting to realize that they also agree. They don't want everybody following them around, and they don't want people being murdered in their name, and they don't want people being murdered with their money. So when you go to these kind of protests, when you go to the protest is not like you go to the protest and then instantly, like, you know, half the army retires. It doesn't work like that. The point is, you go to the protest, you look around, you realize, I'm not alone. The next time, 10 people go out and they go, we're not alone, and then 100 people, and it continues to grow and grow and grow. The idea is, a protest is to celebrate the idea that not the entire country is insane. There are some people who are sane. Here's a song about that. It's called, Keep Your Eyes Open!
We'll be right back.
Thanks to everybody at the Eventworks. Thanks to our friends, the Poster Children, for playing with us. And thanks to you all for being so cool. It's very nice to see you. We'll see you again. Peace.